Let them know what's your niggas clue back. Me too close to my TV. You feel me? Welcome to Uncut No Smart TV, nigga. Nigga, what's your name, nigga?
Chess, nigga, you don't need to know my name, nigga.
Oh, shit.
Welcome to Uncut No Smart. Nigga, come on, bro. Don't do no weird stuff, gang. Just let me know. Who is this, nigga?
Bro, I'm stuck.
You stuck.
I
got you on Uncut No Smart TV, gang. What's your name, bro?
Cut TV, my name is Leek, nigga. You know what's going on, man. You're not coming, man.
You got any
smut
on your name, nigga, clear it up, nigga.
Oh, bro, I ain't got no smoke on my name.
No smut.
I can vouch. Yes, ain't got no smut on it.
No smut.
I got hella haters, though, man. You feel me? I beat all of them, you feel me?
Real Puerto Rican poppy, ain't no smut on my name.
I heard you niggas got some niggas that's in y'all gang.
Bro,
you feel me? How y'all feeling about y'all members, gang?
Yep. Recording in progress.
What it do, man? It's your boy GP the Beast. You know what I'm saying, nigga? This is Uncut No Smut TV. You know what I'm saying? You know, we going crazy out here in Sacramento, Macamento. You know what I'm talking about? Putting it back on the map, nigga, where it's supposed to be. In order to do that, nigga, we got to go back. You know what I'm saying? We going back how it started. And some of the real figures, nigga, that played a part. You know what I'm saying? Today, I got a special guest, nigga, and we're going to talk about what part he played. Man, introduce yourself.
Hey, my name is Young Mone. They call me Mone Black, Mone Park, California, Sacramento, you know, things like that.
Okay, we got Mone in the building around here, man. You know what I'm saying? Man, tell a man, how you played a part in, you know, creating this Sacramento, man, and building it into what it is right now, man. Tell them how, you know what I'm saying, your imprint on this Sacramento, Macamento streets, man.
Oh, man, you know, I started this 12th Avenue gang, you feel me, out here in the hood, you know. And we, you know, we was the ones that, you know, had to do all the dirty work, you feel me? So, you know what I'm saying? We had to keep the hood, hold the hood down, shit like that.
For sure. You and who else started it, man? I know you didn't do it all by yourself. It had to be some real players in the game, you know what I'm saying? If y'all's putting in all the work, definitely it had to be some real niggas involved.
Yeah, man. It's me, my nigga Bear, my nigga Insane, Killer Dirt. Who else? Willow. Insane, L Dog, JB. It's a long list. You feel me?
Hey, nah, there was some. Hey, you didn't name some real hitters, though. There was some real factors right there. You know what I'm talking about? I think it can't do nothing but salute that. So that was that 12th Ave, huh?
Yeah.
So what made y'all, you know, create 12th Ave? You know, we already had Old Park. You know what I'm saying? We already have 4th Ave. You know what I'm saying? What made y'all create 12th Ave?
We wanted our own little establishment. You feel me? So we just came up with the idea to just take over that street right there. Just do what we do right there. And don't let nobody else come over there and do nothing.
So that means other niggas couldn't come, you know, and push their weight. Niggas couldn't sell product. Niggas couldn't even hang out.
Niggas can hang out, but they can't do nothing else. They can't sell no dope over there, or take nobody's shit that was from over there, or nothing like that, or jump nobody from over there, none of that.
So what consisted of 12th Ave, though? What did you have to be to become like a 12th Ave member? Did you have to like live on 12th Ave? Did you have to like have family members on 12th Ave? I mean, how did it establish like, okay, nigga, this 12th Ave?
Day one's elementary school from motherfucking from damn near what, second grade on up. We knew each other, so you feel me? That's what it was. You had to be like from the hood, like born and raised out there.
For sure.
Yeah. We wouldn't just let anybody on.
So but no outsiders and none of that.
Nah.
Nah.
Nope. Everybody was born and raised right there. Fred R. Elementary, Marion Anderson, Caleb Greenwood, Kit Carson, Cal Middle School, all that type of shit.
Okay. Okay. So if you was 12th Ave, you know what I'm saying? Do 12th Ave consist of Zilla or Fab? You know what I'm saying? Or is it just 12th Ave?
Oh, they got a couple, a few homies that's Fab Zilla. Yeah, they got a couple of homies that's Fab and Zilla.
Do 12th Ave consist of any Mozzie members?
I think it do. Yep.
So 12th Ave is still deeply rooted within Oak Park. It's just, you know, certain Oak Park members that it might even claim some other cliques represent 12th Ave.
Yes, sir. Yep. For sure.
Sure.
Yeah, because all that shit, it changed from what it originally was and just came to some whole other shit. You feel me? It's just, so that shit changed.
So how was it in the beginning? What was the forethought of it in the beginning?
In the beginning, we was all outside because we didn't have no internet. So we was all on the block. Niggas was meeting up on the block. Niggas didn't have no phones and none of that. Niggas had to show up to the block to know what's going on.
For sure.
Feel me? Yeah. Oh, they had the little brick phones though. Remember them old school brick phones?
Yeah, I do, man. I was just talking about one the other day. The old school brick phones, man, come in the box right back old, there.
The big ass phones. Yeah, that was back in the days when I was a little nigga, when I was like 10, 11?
Hey, you had to have some money to have one of them too. You had to be a boss.
Yeah, I seen them, I was like, oh, they got these big ass phones back in the days. Hell yeah,
that's real. So that show right there, you've been around for a minute, huh?
Hell yeah, I was around when they had the chain link park that was in the big park that you had to climb over, like the little army chain?
Right, right.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, the army chain on my mama.
Yeah,
God
right
damn.
There. Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah, that's like 81.
Man. Yeah. No, for real.
Yeah.
Nigga, I remember that. You know what I'm talking about? Mm-hmm. Oh, my mama, that's a trip. I never realized it was gone like that.
I was a little ass kid eating chicken and dumplings at that little spot on the corner right there, 6th Avenue and 33rd.
For sure. So you say, you know, that's when niggas was outside on the block, nigga. That's when Task Force, nigga, was doing the jump out boys and nigga got to pay attention to every car coming down the street.
That's when they had that nigga Jim Cooper out there riding around in that blue Chev.
Man, Jim Cooper, niggas don't know about Jim Cooper. You know, he running for the sheriff. I know he was running for sheriff. You know, I know he was, what is he, the mayor of Elk Grove or Elk Grove?
He was a sheriff, boom, and then he went to the mayor, and now he came back as a sheriff.
Right. Niggas don't know that nigga was a detective, nigga, on the streets, nigga, running through Oak Park and the heights, nigga, smashed it on niggas, nigga, being disrespectful.
Hey, that nigga used to be smashing on niggas, and he'd take you to the other gang hood.
Man, take you to the other hood, nigga, and nigga have you in the back seat and pull over on another nigga and sweat that nigga and point at you. Nigga,
yeah,
put
talk
you
about
in the
where
cross.
You from? Yeah. Hell yeah, that nigga
put
wasn't
you in
cool.
The cross, like you told on the nigga or something.
On everything, he was not cool. That nigga,
man,
Cooper
that nigga
was a beast.
That nigga was a beast. That nigga followed me, nigga. Nigga, I used, when the police used to get on me, I used to drive to my mama house all the way. They be pulling me over. I'd be like, nigga, fuck y'all, nigga. I'm going all the way to my mama house. Bro, this nigga knew I was going to my mama house and wasn't pulling over. Bro, this nigga rammed in the back of my car.
Yeah, Cooper was a beast like that. I'm telling you.
Nigga rammed my shit, bro. Like, nigga, pull over.
Yeah. I seen that nigga run through gates chasing niggas. That nigga was a big.
Wasn't that nigga even smoking crack?
I don't know what that nigga was on, but he was crazy.
That nigga was, was it him? Or yeah, that nigga right that, bro. That
they
nigga
had,
was
they
that.
had Peterson, Jeffries, Quinn. Smythe. Remember Smythe?
Man, Smythe nigga was a beast, bro.
Smythe was a beast.
My God, that nigga was a beast. You feel me? And the nigga that the nigga from the Flash killed. Nigga, what was that nigga name? The police? He smacked that nigga. That nigga was a beast, bro. That little young nigga was terrorizing, bro. Him and that nigga Smythe, bro. They was terrorizing.
Them nigga, they was some cold motherfuckers. That was back in the day, too. I remember that shit. I got chastised by Peterson. I was on San Jose Way, and I walked in front of his squad car with a red rag in my pocket. They hit my ass up, took me all the way back up San Jose to San Jose and 8th, and made a right and parked the car, nigga, and got in the back seat on me, nigga, and was like chastising the nigga, like, and but at the end of that, nigga, they gave me the rag back and let me out of the car.
Yeah.
I was like 12, 13.
See, niggas don't know, nigga. The police was gangster back then.
Yeah, they was tripping back then. They wasn't playing. They was nigga, shooting niggas.
The police that killed my brother, the nigga Dirty Red, he killed my brother and shot Paul, nigga, and shot his eye out. That's why One Eye Paul was out here for a while. That nigga caught me in the Heights and was taking me to jail. The nigga was taking me to jail for, I only had weed, but the nigga was taking me to jail for crack cocaine, talking about I had white specks in the bag. Nigga, on the way to the jail, I said, nigga, fuck y'all, I'm talking shit. I said, I don't like you motherfuckers anyway. One of you niggas killed my brother. Nigga, that nigga hit the brakes on me, bruh. Turned around and looked at me and said, nigga, I killed your brother. Nigga, and if you keep talking, you might not make it to the county jail.
Oh, yeah, nigga, see?
Fuck me up, nigga. Yeah. I'm in the back seat. I'm just a little nigga, but I'm on my ball and I'm coming up.
The
nigga fucked me up. Nigga, the police that was with him, his passenger, he looked at me real serious. He said, hey, man, bro, just don't say nothing, bro. Just sit back, bro. Don't say nothing, bro. Hey, nigga, I felt that nigga, bro. That nigga made me feel like he was finna take me somewhere, nigga, and kill me, nigga.
Man, that's how I be feeling every time they put me in the back of the motherfucking car.
Yeah, that's crazy. Hey, so that 12th Ave, you say y'all was putting in work, man. Y'all was the niggas putting in work. Could you give us a little idea of that there, what kind of work y'all was putting in?
Oh, we was putting it in, bro. I ain't gonna lie to you, bro. It was like every day with us. We was taking trips.
Hey, they say, you know, quiet as kept, man. They say you like that nigga Vine, man. That nigga Vine from Chicago on the under, man.
Oh, yeah. Nigga was taking trips, I ain't gonna lie. It was down. It was going down with the enemigos. Oh, yeah, they was getting it. Like they was getting it every day. Yeah, from Martin Luther King all the way to G Parkway.
So they know about 12th Ave, huh?
Hell yeah, they know about it for sure. Yeah.
You know, the rappers, man, they don't really bring up 12th Ave that much in the music, man. Why is that?
Shit. I don't know. None of the rappers, they don't. Except Mozzie. Mozzie bring up 12 all the time.
He do?
Hell yeah.
Yeah, he do be bringing up 12th Ave.
Yeah.
But it seems like the world just know Park by 4th Avenue, huh?
Yeah, they did, because, you know, 4th Avenue, that's like the famous little area right there. That's the foundation. So, that, of course, they got to mention that, because that's the foundation. That's where it all
started. That's the heart of it.
Yeah.
That's where it all started.
Where it all started. Before they was claiming 4th Avenue, it was Pebble Beach.
That part.
And then they say
Sean Collins was the one that named it the beach.
Oh, yeah.
You heard that too?
Yeah, I heard that.
Yeah, man. Salute and shout out, you know, and rest in peace, Sean Collins. You know, a real nigga. You know what I'm saying? That played a major part in this Sacramento shit. You know, I used to look up to the nigga. When I was a little nigga, you know what I'm saying? I seen him pushing with Patty Parker, and nigga, when he had the Lincoln nigga on the motherfucking days or something.
Yeah, the Black Lincoln. I remember that motherfucker too.
With the suicide doors.
Yeah, with the suicide doors. He had a little crazy. He had his Jerry curl.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, used to be wearing a Dodgers hat.
For sure. You know what I'm saying? Nigga, you know what I'm saying? He one of them niggas that I recognized and looked up to, you know, coming up and shit. You know what I'm saying?
He was a real figure.
So, man, you know, a lot of people don't know, but you know, I grew up around there, man, sitting on the on that porch, you know, Fourth Avenue. That's my grandma, Miss Usher. You know what I'm saying? So,
right there, know, what's that, San Carlos?
Right there on Fourth Avenue, exactly. And right there next to La Soledad. You feel me?
Did she own the other house right there too, next to the apartments, the house that go upstairs?
Yeah, to go up the stairs?
Yeah.
Next to the apartments. That's what I'm talking about, the main house, the yellow house.
Yeah,
It used to be yellow back in the day. Them steps used to be hella long to me, right?
Yep.
I remember being on them steps, man, and Lee Bell Murphy, nigga, come through, nigga, in his Cadillac and shit. Watching my Uncle Marcus come through, nigga, he had the white Eldorado with the T-tops in it. You know what I'm saying? I remember watching them niggas, man. It's crazy. Yep.
Hell yeah. That shit used to be upset.
Yeah, man, it was some good old days back in the day. You know what I'm saying? That's when my brother Conrad was alive. Rest in peace.
Yeah, them used to be the days right there.
So you say 12th Avenue changed because as time went on, other cliques was developed, but them was still your niggas, but niggas started feeling other things as well as time went on, right?
Yeah. They got into some other, you know, little cliques and stuff like that. That's when a nigga went to jail.
That's when you went to jail?
Yeah, I went to jail and shit. And then the other shit started, the cliques and all that shit started. Well, it had already started, but I'm talking about like when I went to jail, that's when I started hearing about the Zilla and all that.
Right. Yeah, you know, when a nigga go to jail, things change. Speaking of jail, let's talk about one of your incidences in jail. You done did a lot of time, right?
Yeah, I did like 13 years and 6 months.
Now, I remember you told me about a time when it was a white boy, was it a white boy Crip that was on the yard, same yard you was on, and it ended up starting some funk?
Oh, yeah, the white boy Crip was on the yard at Old Folsom.
Tell us a little bit of how that went down.
Okay, the white boy Crip was on the yard, right? But at the same time, the motherfucking skinheads was like, I guess they was like pressing him, like he can't be there or whatever. They was trying to put that issue down. So they was coming together because in Old Folsom, they had a Sacramento area. But in the front of it, they had what they called them, I think it's some NC or some shit.
Yeah, NC, the Northern Crips.
Yeah, so they was right there in the front, right there. They had a little table right there. So they was talking the shit right there. The motherfuckers was like, what's going to go around and shit? So they gave the white boy, the ultimatum is like, they gave him a banger. And so the motherfucking skinheads kept walking back and forth, like doing everything.
Hold on. Who gave him a banger? Like the Crips? What Crips was he running with?
The Northern Crips.
Oh, yeah. He was running with the whole NC car.
Right.
But where was he from?
I don't know. I think he was from like San Jose somewhere. Or Fresno, one of them. He's from one of them areas.
So, okay.
Yeah, so they gave him a banger. It was like, you know what I'm saying? Next time one of these motherfuckers walk by here, you know what I'm saying? You do your shit or whatever they told him. So the white boy skinhead, he walking by, he got his shirt off. He got a big ass swastika on his back, like this big. That motherfucker was hella big, right? So nigga, he walked by one time. I'm like, what's up with this motherfucker? He keep walking by this motherfucker. And the homies was getting like uncomfortable because it's like what he gonna do? So he walked by like one more time, and then he came back and the white boy Crip bust on him. And he go up.
They didn't have no words or nothing.
Cause he already knew what it was. So when he get the busting on him, the other white boys, they start running over there and whatever, doing whatever they thought they was gonna do. But I'm looking, I'm like, oh, they going now. It's like every time one get up and try to run, where, you know what I'm saying, they going out.
I'm like, niggas, the Crips, the NCs?
Bro, the NCs, nigga, some of the homies ran up in there. We was all right there, right in the midst of it, right there. But the whole thing was, the Crip Square was right there. So it's like, y'all didn't, what make y'all do that? It's like 50 right. Crips right there in that square right there. Just chilling right there. I'm like, that was stupid. It was like right. Five or six white boys and whatever, however many other white boys it was, nigga. Man, white boys got the shit beat out of them so fast, it wasn't even funny.
And this was at Old Folsom.
And that was at Old Folsom. 2000, and was that, 7? Yeah, 2007.
2007? I was up there. Was I up 2007? There?
Yeah, you came. I think you came like a little bit after.
A little after that, huh?
A little bit after that, yep. Because when I came, it was already going down with them because they already had some shit going on with them already when I had first came. So it was already some funk in the air anyway. So they just, you feel me? They just made it just go. It was basically like, nigga, before I came, they said they was catching niggas slipping.
Oh, they was catching niggas slipping?
Yeah, and they was cutting niggas. The white boys at Old Folks, and they was like, they catch some niggas out of bounds and try to, you feel me, and was doing whatever they was doing. So, and I guess they started like on a modified program, they started letting niggas out or whatever. So every time it used to go down all the time though with the white boys. Yeah. They had that I came.
When you say the white boy Crip busted on him, so he hit him a few times with that thing.
Oh yeah, he hit him a few times. He had the little swastika leaking.
But did nobody die?
Nah, didn't nobody die though.
Niggas just got injured.
Niggas, they got injured. Didn't know niggas getting injured. It was too many niggas. you got the Sacramento area right here, and then you got the Bay Area right there, next to that, and then the Crip Square is right there by right behind the basketball court. It was all niggas right there.
Yeah, I know how that shit is. I don't see why they would have did that. It was like. Seemed like they was trying to pump fear when they knew niggas wasn't scared. But I mean, what was it?
Man, whatever it was, I think they was on the crash course trying to get away from Old Folsom.
Yeah, because it seemed like it was suicidal, huh?
Yeah, because the way I'm like, y'all, it ain't no way y'all can win a ride right here, man. Y'all was been better off trying that shit on seeing a few niggas or him and three or four other niggas right walking somewhere or something. Because here is bad. When y'all try that right here, it's bad. That's a green light on y'all.
It's bad. You feel me?
It's all bad.
Unless they thought the Mexicans was going to help them or something.
That's what they probably did think that, but the Mexicans ain't helped their stupid ass.
Hey, they must have thought the Mexicans was going to help them.
They probably did.
You know that's what they be doing. They be lining with the Mexicans like, nigga, if it become a race riot, nigga, y'all going to help us. And automatically, if a white get on a black, it's going to become a race riot. You feel me?
Right. Hell
that's
yeah.
What happens. That's what happens when like white boy Crips or white boy Bloods come into prison. It's always a 99.9%. It's going to be a riot over there because the white boys ain't finna have that. They hate it. You know, when one of their own cross over, they hate that.
Nigga, I seen some white boys getting into it with some white boys at High Desert. Some skinheads getting into it with some Woods.
Oh yeah, that didn't happen a few times too.
They was beefing.
That High Desert. It was really funking up.
They had a little power struggle with swords. I'm like, where they get these motherfucking knives at?
They went out there with swords. They was trying to kill each other.
Man, they was trying to kill each other, bro.
What?
Hell yeah. On D-Card, High Desert.
Damn.
Yeah, a nigga
don't never see that.
Yeah, nigga, on D-Card when I was up there at High Desert. think it was like 2008.
Wow.
Yeah, 2008. Hell man. Yeah. Yeah, that was beefy.
White boys was trying to kill each other, huh?
Yeah, they was trying to get to each other. I think they was having a little power struggle.
Hey, you know, the skinheads, they feel a different way than the woods do.
Yeah, they do. They do. They be trying to press their issue.
Yeah, they feel like they more gangster. They more thug. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Hell yeah.
And they hate niggas more.
I remember one time, was that old Folsom? One of them yards. I was on one of them yards, nigga. They was walking the. No, that was at Tracy when I was at Tracy. They used to be at Tracy geeking too. That's when I first went to prison.
Oh yeah, Tracy. That's where a lot of us. Yeah, we all when we first go to prison, a lot of us that went through Tracy as that first go around.
Yeah, they was the skinheads walking around the yard. You know what I'm saying? Acting like they was real tough. They had a little, what's the name they was doing? I'm like, what the fuck is they doing? That was my first time, too, in the California prison. I went to prison in the past, too, though.
Was it in the summer or the winter? Because either time is terrible. If it's in the summer, you in there burning up. If it's in the winter time, is you in there freezing because all the windows is knocked out. So just tell me, was it in the summer or the winter?
I think it was in the summertime.
You was in there burning up, huh?
Burning up, nigga. Hot as a bitch up in there. Little was ass. The
window, little window broke out. Windows broke out.
Hell yeah. They be on the chair encouraging motherfuckers to break the window.
Yeah, hey, niggas still be rapping and all that outside the window in the back.
Yep.
Hell
yep.
Yeah. Hey, and the water is so dirty, it's brown.
Yep. I remember I was up in. Hey, I was at Tracy. I heard the weirdest shit. You know they be doing the shut. You know they be doing the shutdown.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the shutdown.
They had this weird nigga from 29th Street on the shutdown, right? This man go send a shutdown to the woods. I'm like, is he serious right now? That was the weirdest shit I ever heard.
That nigga sent the shutdown to the woods.
To the woods, bro. I was like, is this nigga crazy? Yeah, the homies is like, did you hear this nigga? And that was the craziest shit of my prison experience right there.
No, that was like, crazy.
Wow. That's like that an insult.
That was crazy. Hey, man, Tracy will make a nigga never want to go to prison again. I don't know why it didn't break me. You know what I'm talking about? You know, I didn't get the mail from my bro for like 2 weeks later.
Nigga, High Desert will make a nigga never want to go to prison, nigga.
For real?
Man, I swear.
What feeling did it give you, man? What did it do to you?
Nigga, they had us on lockdown forever, damn near seemed like. They made us go through anger management just to come out the cell.
Is that right?
Hell yeah, we had to go through anger management, nigga. And then they was bringing us out of handcuffs, sitting us on the bench so we could talk to each other.
Right, to try to figure it out, huh?
So they were trying to figure it out at High Desert.
How long y'all was on lockdown?
Nigga, when I had first got there, the lockdown lasted, I think, what, 6 months?
Nigga, you got to look up at the camera, nigga. What you do? You got caught.
When I had first got there, nigga, it was like 6 months.
6 months?
Yep, then we came out for a little bit. I think we came out, it was like around April or some shit like that. Nigga, then we went back on lockdown to like around Christmas. I'm like, what the fuck? Because, nigga, motherfuckers was dropping kites on us, like, talking about the blacks is going to do something. They got a kite talking about the blacks is going to do something. Shit like, they was getting shit like that, locking us down.
Was this about the White Boy Crip or about another incident?
Nah, this is about a High Desert.
Right. Oh, yeah, this was at High Desert. But why they say the black was tripping on the whites at High Desert?
Oh, they was tripping up there, too, the blacks and the whites, too. They had a riot on, what yard was that? I think C yard, where they had a riot. That was the biggest riot. That's why we was locked down still. That was a big ass riot with the whites and the blacks.
What year was that?
I think it was like it happened like around 2000 or 2001, because I got there in 2002. So it was like around one of them, either 2000 or 2001.
So look, man, I done been to a lot of prisons, right? Federal and state. But I ain't never been to High Desert. I've been to Susanville across the street, but I've never been to High Desert. But I heard a lot of stories about High Desert. Is High Desert really as vicious as the stories say?
Man, listen, High Desert is the coldest motherfucker. But look, I seen the motherfuckers, right? I seen a motherfucking tower police watching nigga get stabbed. Was in the tower looking right at the scene, nigga, and walked away from the window. Nigga went and sat down. What?
Watch the nigga get stabbed, huh?
Watch the nigga get stabbed. Don't come up there and you a pedophile or child molester or something like that. Oh, they about to let you get cooked. They gonna let you get cooked up there for sure.
I heard it was really racist too. I heard the officers was racist.
It's hella racist. The police is hella racist up there. Hella racist, nigga. They fuck up niggas every day. They be fucking niggas up every day at High Desert. Torturing niggas. I'm telling you, they be torturing niggas at High Desert for no reason.
Like hell. Like, what do you mean by torture? Like, what kind of ways?
Like, nigga, have a nigga hemmed up, handcuffed, nigga, and just on his tippy toes, nigga, just for hell alone, nigga, and they just throw you in a cage, nigga. You feel me? Yeah, they was running up in niggas' cells and shit. Niggas talking shit to them, nigga. They flipping niggas. Just doing hella crazy shit.
Yeah, I heard they had something up there like the Green Wall or something, like the police against the inmates, but the whites had favor with them. You know what I'm saying? This is what I kind of like heard, and you know what I mean?
The white boys do got favor with the motherfuckers. Cause I be wondering, like, how these motherfuckers get these big ass knives in here? Where they getting this shit
from? Bruh. Where's
metal work from? Like, come on, bruh. These look like some motherfucking real knives. I ain't talking about no shit that's, you feel me? I'm talking about this. These motherfuckers look like some real shit. Like, nigga, where y'all get this shit from? I done seen some shit cut off the locker and all that, but I ain't seen no shit like that. Shining. Sharp to the motherfucker look like some other shit. Bro, what the fuck?
Hey, this shit came out of Walmart, huh?
Man, come on, bro. I've seen some shit now. You feel me? Yeah.
Hey, that's crazy, bro. That is crazy.
Yeah, luckily for me, I went to the cell with the homie that just had came off of death row.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, that nigga was teaching me all kind of shit, though. That nigga was a cold nigga, too.
He was on death row. He got love.
Yeah, he got off death row. He came. He was in the county. He was in the prison with us. He was in the county. Look to the pen.
So, I wanted to ask you, you know, when you up there in the High Desert, and it snow up there a lot, right? It's snowing and rain, right?
Yeah, it's snowing shit, yep.
So when the alarm go off, do they make you prone out in the snow?
Nigga, get down, nigga, or get shot. Better have a plastic bag with you, nigga, for real. Niggas, at High Desert, niggas, we carry a plastic bag to the yard when they know it's cold outside, it's snowing. Nigga, niggas, we have plastic bags on them in their pocket, nigga, everywhere.
You got to.
Nigga, on that motherfucker, they want you to prone out, nigga, get the fuck down. Nigga, and they be tripping.
They be tripping. Bro, when I was in Susanville, they said, get down. I'm like, I'm not used to getting all the way down. So I'm getting down, sitting in my little squat. They like, bro, GP, bro, you got to get all the way down. You got to lay down. I'm like, lay down, nigga? It's raining. What you talking about? It's snowing like. Bro, GP, serious. You got to lay down, bro. They coming. Look, nigga, they coming.
Yeah. Them motherfuckers at High Desert wasn't cool, I ain't gonna lie. Them motherfuckers was not cool. Don't be on lockdown. Wait to serve a nigga his food and shit. That shit be cold and shit. They be playing games.
Food be cold. It be nasty
cold.
Too, huh?
Nasty than the motherfucker. Nigga be mad already. Nigga up in there starving. Nigga don't even eat that. Nigga put, wrap that shit up and put that shit on the shelf and go back to sleep. Hell yeah. That shit was terrible.
But damn near lockdown be the most safest time for a nigga though, huh?
Damn, yeah, them lockdown. I ain't gonna lie, them lockdowns be the safest time for a nigga.
That's one time you can let your guard down a little bit, huh?
Yeah, just a little bit. Just a little bit. Still gotta be extra careful, though, because you don't know they got crazy cuckoo motherfuckers that be slipping handcuffs and be on some other shit still, too. You know how be catching niggas, like, if you be on lockdown and the other race ain't on lockdown, niggas, they be trying to try shit, too.
For sure. Yeah, they'll try to put a nigga, separate a nigga on shower time, put him on the wrong side. You know what I'm talking about? Where another nigga got action at getting to you.
Yep, playing. They be playing.
They be playing.
Too motherfucking much.
One time we was on lockdown. Nigga, we all on lockdown. It's us against the Mexicans. We in Old Folsom. And nigga, we going to chow. It's our tier. We going to chow. You know, I got my niggas. I got me. I got my Sally. I got my other two niggas on the tier, and I got my other two niggas. You know, we going to walk together. Nigga, you know, it's folk time. Yeah. Nigga, these niggas going to stop me at the end of the tier. Black cop. He like, hey, bro, come on. Let me search you. And I'm like, search me? And he like, yeah. I'm like, bro, why the fuck would you do that? Nigga, why you trying to pull me off the line, nigga, and let my niggas leave me like that, nigga? You already know it's a war going on, nigga. You trying to put me in a fucked up situation? Nigga, this is some weird shit you doing, blood. You know what I'm saying? He like, nigga, I'm just doing my job. Nah, nigga, you ain't doing your job, nigga. You playing with my motherfucking life right now, nigga.
Yeah, they be playing. I'm telling you, they be playing games. They ain't trying to play you.
Yeah, man. Hey, man. Hey, so, yeah, man. So, it's obviously you done been in the trenches. You know what I'm saying? You done been putting in work, nigga, in the pen and on the street. You know what I mean? You done seen it. A lot of people ain't experienced a lot of the things that you done been through. A lot of people talk about it, you know what I'm saying? But they don't really experience it. You done been through a few. You done been to some real prisons. What prisons you done been to?
High Desert, fucking, you sent me from High Desert, I went to Old Folsom. I went from Old Folsom back to High Desert. And then I went from High Desert to motherfucking Calipat. They sent me to Calipat. And then from Calipat, I went from High Desert to motherfucking New Delano, 180. And then I went from New Delano to motherfucking Salinas Valley. And then I went from Salinas Valley to Vacaville. And then from Vacaville back to High Desert. And then where I go from there? I went from Vacaville to back to High Desert. And then from there, I went to fucking Arizona. And then from Arizona.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you was out of state. You even went out of state.
Yeah, I went out of state.
Yeah, because when you go to Arizona, that's out of state. That's when the prisons is overcrowded. They send a nigga out of state. Out of state. They say out of state is better. Is out of state better?
Yeah, out of state is a little bit better. It's a little bit more dangerous, but it's better though.
Why is it more dangerous? It would seem like it's less dangerous.
Cause they got like little security guards, like type of shit. They don't got CDC officers. They got like little security guards type of shit.
With guns?
They don't got no guns.
So why is it more dangerous though?
They just got block guns.
And they trigger happy, they'll shoot your ass?
They scary as fuck.
So where's the more dangerous? Oh, it's dangerous with the inmates.
Yeah, with the inmates, not with the police.
Yeah, because the inmates gonna go crazy. They like, fuck these niggas up.
Yeah, because they ain't doing, they like some fake security guards, like type of shit.
Right.
Yeah.
But that also give you action to that manipulating their ass too, huh?
Yeah, they was for sure getting manipulated. Nigga, Arizona was booming.
Yeah, it was hustling,
Arizona,
huh?
Arizona was the highest I ever been in my life. I was higher in Arizona than I ever been on the streets. I ain't lying to you. What?
You feel me?
Yeah. Yep.
Hey,
yep.
They have PlayStation up in there, huh?
Yep, Xboxes and all that, yep.
Nigga, that's incredible, bro. I ain't never had that in prison, bro.
Nigga, they was running it in, nigga. They was bringing it in.
I'd have been happy up there, bro.
Bro, they was running it in. I'm talking about they was running it in, bro. The homie came back one time with the bundle, nigga. And soon as he walked through the door, nigga, I was like, what the fuck, bro? Bro, you is hot right now, my nigga. You got this whole motherfucker lit up. I'm talking about the whole day room lit up.
Lit
up, nigga. I can smell that nigga as soon as he hit the door. I'm like, bro, you got to put something on that, bro. You are loud, nigga.
Wow.
Nigga, hella loud, nigga. I'm talking about, nigga, that nigga was loud. Nigga smelled like he had a pound on him.
Wow.
What was going on? Hey,
I heard bitches was selling pussy up in there.
Oh, yeah, they was selling pussy up in there. Niggas was knocking the freestyles, though.
They was knocking them up.
They was knocking them. They was getting knocked left and right. They were so loose and so vulnerable. It was like easy. Niggas.
I was hearing that. Wasn't Spooky B up there?
Spooky B? I don't think Spooky B was in Arizona with us.
Who was up there with you from California?
That nigga, you know, that nigga Slap Rock was up there.
Slap Rock was up there?
Yeah, Slap Rock.
Yeah?
Yeah, Slap Rock was there.
Okay, for sure.
It was a few cats there with us. From out of sack, it was a few cats.
Yeah.
Yep.
Niggas was getting along.
Yeah, niggas was getting along for sure.
For sure. To get along. You feel me?
Hell yeah.
So man, after your experience of doing prison time and starting 12th Avenue and going to jail and coming home, then what was it like then, man? Well, did it seem like the family, the 12th Avenue family was still there, or a whole lot had changed?
A whole lot of shit had changed, but the niggas were still there. We still be kicking in the shit today. We still fucking around with it. Having a little gatherings, little get-togethers and shit. We still fuck with each other regularly.
For sure. So what you think about, you know, how to... You know, the young life is doing out here, man, how they moving and shit, how, you know, niggas is, you know what I mean, you know, stuck in their four block radiuses and, you know, smashing on the microphone, on the rap, you know, about killing a nigga that live a few blocks down the street and, you know, just, you know, the craziness, man, which, how you feel about it, man?
I mean, sometimes that shit get a little bit old. Feel me? But shit, that's what's happening now, though. That's what niggas is doing. So it ain't like how the rap game used to be. When motherfuckers used to be rapping, there used to be like a message in it. That shit just played out.
Huh.
It used to be like a message in the rap. You know what I'm talking about?
I do.
Motherfuckers were trying to get across a message. Nowadays, it's just like niggas trying to lead you into a sale.
It's crazy. I remember that message. When you just said that, you reminded me of the song. The song actually called The Message when rap first really was coming out. And I was a young nigga. And I specifically remember the nigga said, you got to have a kind in this man in this land of milk and honey. You feel me?
Yeah.
And I used to think the nigga said, you got to have a car, right?
Yeah.
Because I wanted a car so bad. You got to have a car in this land of milk and honey because I felt if I got a car, I'm going to come up, man. You know what I'm talking about?
Hell yeah.
But he said, you got to have a kind. But like you said, it was a message. You know what I'm talking about?
Message. Motherfuckers was delivering a message.
Now the message is, nigga, we don't love anything black that grew up across the street and we're going to kill it.
See, that's a fucked up message right there. You feel me? You used to motherfuckers dropping matches and a little bit of game in the rap game. Now it's just like niggas just trying to kill niggas off. They making it worse, really, if you really think about it. Niggas is making it, they ain't taking advantage of their voice.
They're not understanding that they got the voice that they got to give, and that they need to start talking about some real shit, right?
And they need to utilize that gift, bring motherfuckers together instead of, you feel me, separate motherfuckers.
That part, you know, yeah. I'm with all that. You know, all they, you know, I try to tell them, man, all they got to do is expand their game, man. You know, expand it from 4 blocks to 8 blocks, man. 8 blocks to 16 blocks. You know what I'm talking about? Make it bigger, man. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Eventually, it'll be big enough where it'll be the whole city. Why the whole city can't be one? Nigga, we'll be more powerful. You feel me?
Exactly.
More powerful.
Way more powerful.
Niggas don't have to keep fucking baby mamas that live in the same neighborhood, nigga, where all the kids gonna grow up related to each other, nigga. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah.
That's funny you said that, because everybody don't park damn near related.
Man, everybody related, man, because everybody gonna fuck the same little females, nigga. And now, with this gang shit, niggas don't feel comfortable going to fuck nothing else outside the hood, nigga. Because, nigga, you not finna catch me slipping. You feel me? And then if you do fuck around and have a baby by a bitch in the other hood, you like, nigga, bitch, I'm not going to keep coming over there, nigga. You know what I'm talking about?
You got to see nigga sneak over there and shit. They got to go over there strapped and all that.
Man, that's not a good feeling, man. You know what I'm saying? The pussy ain't worth it after that, right?
Nah, it ain't worth that risk. It ain't worth catching no case.
And niggas is missing out on, you know, actually doing music with each other. Niggas don't subscribe to each other's shit, don't like each other's shit, don't view each other's shit. Nigga, this is crazy. We hella missing out on these numbers. These numbers that could be putting money in our pocket. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah. Nigga could get way more money if niggas came together and put that bullshit.
Way more money. Shows. You know what I'm talking about? Shows. Nigga, each one teach one. Nigga, whoever popping, bring the rest along. You feel me? And make it pop. Make it pop. You feel me?
Yeah. Sure.
Hey, man, I really enjoyed the interview, man. You know what I mean? We learned a whole lot about you. You know what I'm saying? It's obvious you one of them niggas who done put in work. You know, you deserve a salute. You know what I'm saying? You deserve to be on the channel, man, uncut, no smut. You ain't got no smut on your name, right?
Nah, I don't got no smut. If it is, we can clean it up.
Because if it is, we can clean it up, man. This is where we clean it up, man.
Yeah.
But
put some clarity on it.
But you, nigga, you heard it, nigga. My nigga ain't got no smut on him, nigga. And the nigga done been to damn near what? I done heard about 7 prisons he done been in, even in California, in the state and out of state. Then been in all kind of interactions. You know what I'm saying? Which means, you know, when a nigga go to that many prisons, you know what I was saying to myself in my head? I said, yeah, that nigga was putting in work because he kept getting in trouble. That's why they kept transferring his ass. But, you know, sometimes they transfer you to lower your points as well, too. But then you get back in trouble when you go back. When you go back to the same prisons that you was already at, you fucked up, nigga, when your points got low.
On everything. And my first time in prison wasn't even in California, though. My first time in prison was in Nevada.
You was out in Reno hustling?
I was in Reno.
Oh, yeah. I remember when niggas was up there, they was up there getting money, huh?
Yeah, it was cracking in Reno. I'm talking about cracking. Nigga, I used to take a 200 count from the hood and go out there and make them near 1,000.
You serious?
On the gang.
I was slipping the whole time, huh?
Hell yeah. It was slipping the whole time.
killing it.
Nigga, hey, you just made me realize I was slipping the whole time.
Yeah.
I seen all them niggas out there, too. Them nigga, my heist niggas was out there. They was living out there getting money, nigga, balling out there.
Yep. They still out there.
They still, niggas still out there?
Yeah, they still out there.
Man, I went out there one time. That motherfucker looked like a ghost town. Reno looked like, nigga, everybody moved out.
Yeah. I went out there. It didn't look the same, though. I should look hella different.
Depression. I think, remember when we had that depression?
Yeah.
Oh, the COVID, maybe. No, it was the depression because I was in prison on the COVID. I ain't been to Reno since. But on the depression, I went back. That shit looked empty, nigga.
Yeah, it don't look the same. That shit is empty. They probably was cracking down on motherfuckers.
Yeah.
Who's out there? That motherfucker was shooking. Yep. I went to prison fucking around out there.
So what's next for my nigga Mom, man? What's next?
Oh, man, you know, me, man. I open-minded situation with me, man. You feel me?
Shit.
See how this shit play out.
Well, man, you know, we're going to keep trying to take it to the next level. Nigga, it was a pleasure to have you on the show. I appreciate you. I salute you. You're my nigga. It's Uncut Don't Smut. I love you. Yeah. You know what I'm talking about?
Yep. And, like, bro, you know, I'm out here right here in the area.
Nigga, right. I'm going to pull up on you. I'm going to pull up on you, nigga, and we're going to go blow some and turn a few corners and shit. It's good.
Yeah. Yep.
It's good. I got you locked in. Yeah, your boy GP the Beast, man. Shout out our gang. Fill his pocket up with some chain. I just want to talk to him. Tried to smut my name. But niggas know I'm about it.
I'm about it.
And what fucked me up is the niggas that spoke about
niggas
it.
Who spoke
niggas
about
that
it.
Didn't even defend me. They don't know I know about it.
They don't know.
What really fucked me up, the hater side was the most crowded. I don't claim clicker, but I do be around it.
I'm around
and
it.
When I leave the house, I don't never leave without it.
Never.
I don't never sleep without it. Shit, I can't even eat without it. I got it when I'm getting my dick sucked. Can't even freak without it. First thing waking up, I don't brush my teeth without it.
I don't brush.
When I'm in the city, I don't slide through the streets without it.
I don't slide.
Niggas might catch me slipping if I be without it.
If I be
so
without
to leave home without it, I would never think about it. Mozzie and E. Mozzie, my neph. Don't even think about it.
Never.
Born with this game. Shit, I would never eat without it.
Never.
They gave me 17. I couldn't believe I got it. Thought I was through with money, but I refused to believe I got it. Bitch ass nigga snitch. Forced me to take a plea about it. Talk shit behind my back. No time to think about it. Ain't no running from the phone, nigga. I gotta go see about it. And it gotta be a body before we could talk peace about it. Talk shit on the net. Shit, we in the streets about it.
We in the streets.
Oh, you know about a body, nigga? Don't even speak about it. Hey, nigga ain't built to actually be a body.
Okay.
And if it ain't no paperwork, nigga, then why you speak about it?
Quit talking.
Where you from? The Heights or Old Park? They always ask about it. I'm a product of both, nigga, and I'ma smash about it.
Nigga,
I always wanted this money. I still dream about it. So cracked to the city by any means about it.
By any means.
I could have been a tycoon, nigga. I thought about it.
Thought about
but
it.
A nigga still a goon, nigga. Ain't no doubt about
ain't
it.
No doubt
the
about
bitch
it.
Wanted a freak. Shit, wasn't no doubt about
ain't
it.
No doubt
told
about
the bitch
it.
I'm cool. She got dismissed and got outed. She pouted. I thought about it.
Thought
I made
about
a call
it.
About it. What she thought? Since I've been gone, I wasn't about
I
it.
Wasn't
I got the
it.
Game from the dope fiend. Trap house had them crowded.
Crowd.
Nigga, they know the fiends. They taught me how to reroute it.
How
to repackage it up. Shit, I had to recount it. I'm a legend in the city. Missed shot and I'ma rebound it. Respected on the block. Better ask the streets about
ask
it.
Streets,
been locked
nigga.
Up in the pen. Shit, I hate to think about it. I've been neglected a lot, shit, but I'm cool about it.
Nigga,
nigga
cool.
Shot at me and missed, and that nigga made the news about it.
Recognizing
my mistake, nigga, I ain't no fool about it. I got motion in these streets, and I can't move without it.
Never.
Mama gave me some game, I wasn't too keen about it. I rejected it a lot, but I was unforeseen
now,
about
mama.
It. No warning shots in the pen, shit, you better read about it. Catch your body in the pen and let they folks read about it.
The bitch said she loved me, but her movements made me doubt it. She wasn't in the visiting room and that motherfucker was crowded.
Right, it was crowded.
Nigga say I went bad, shit, nigga, I heard about it. But no paperwork exists on the case with my words about it. Nigga say I robbed my nigga mama, how you think I feel about it? That nigga mama like my mama, I'm ready to kill about it. If our city come together, nigga, we should kill about it. Everybody buy each other music, let's get a meal about it. Lil GP and GP3, they with it and they bout it. Them little niggas clone me, ain't no doubt about it. Doing shit that I do with the same route about it. It's like doing business with myself, all we do is count it. Never understood why they hate, I would just think about it. I'm trying to figure this shit out so I could teach about it. I had datings on every car, the streets would speak about it. Went to the feds, extra five for packing heat about it. Got stripped for the crown, used to be the king but got out it. But my nep took it over, so I'm really proud about it. Niggas made decisions and split the hood about it. They can't love you like I do, they didn't grow up around it.
No.
Got my first kick at 15, I'm really about it. Really my brother got smacked by the rollers, I had to read about it. Being black can fuck you up, who gon' teach about it? If the culture is fucked up, who the one who gon' preach about it? Who gon' talk about it? Who gon' walk the walk about it? My closest nigga let me down, but I don't talk about it. Like my other nigga got at my bitch, I never spoke about it. In return, I fucked this bitch and made a joke about it. We settled the shit, we smoked and had a drink about it. We dapped, saluted, and decided not to speak about it. These niggas keep testing me and I always beast about it. So I had a word with God and asked him what he think about it.
What you think, God?